guys, it is Tristan with Nerdette's Newsstand, and we are going to talk about the best books of the week. And normally, I have one that is pretty bad, but this week, weirdly enough, I actually don't have one for the worst of the week. So I did add in a couple honorable mentions here, because there was a lot of good, and I kind of skipped out on anything bad, so I want to make sure I give credit where it is due. So let's talk about the honorable mentions first. And for that, I actually have two books. One is Moon Knight number 6. I have consistently been enjoying Moon Knight. It is by Jed MacKay and the art is by Alessandro Cappuccino. I am so sure that is not what it is, but I'll put it up on the screen. And then for my other one, I have Maw number 4. Now, Maw number 4, I have had kind of, Maw in general, I have had a love-hate relationship with. It almost lost me until this issue. It is by Jude Ellison, and I am really kind of like, where is this story going? I'm going to give it a chance, but it is very kill all men, pro-feminist. It is very weird. But I do like the fact that it is exploring this idea, and these feminists within it are in a cult, and they are clearly the villain. So I'm going to give it a couple more issues and see where it goes, but it almost did lose me. It really did. But if you are new to the channel and enjoy comic books or this type of content, make sure you hit subscribe. As always, hit like and leave me a comment down below. Let me know what your pick of the week was. We will shortly get to mine, but for number 5, I actually have Catwoman Lonely City number 2. Now, this book is really quite different, and it is by Cliff Chang, the art and the writing. Now, this book is good. It is slowly winning me over, but it is something to get used to seeing Selena as older. Now, it's very weird to me because I actually didn't have a problem seeing Bruce older. I didn't have a problem seeing Superman older. But when it's Selena, I'm like, okay, what are we doing here? And it actually is really good. I love the way Killer Croc is in this book. I love that. I love him kind of as that anti-hero anyway, right? Like they did with Earth One. But I am enjoying this story. We get to see Selena kind of get back in shape, see where this is going. This whole election is happening and she's got to get into the Batcave. One thing I will say that I do not like about this book in particular is Barbara Gordon. I don't like the way she's portrayed. She's acting like Bruce giving his money away would solve all the problems. And I'm honestly kind of at the point where I'm sick of hearing that because it's so erroneous and it happens over and over again, right? So for number 4, I have Darkhold Spider-Man. Yeah, I have two books this week from Marvel, believe it or not. Now, I haven't been following the Darkhold books. I know it's a whole like mini event or whatever. This book, oh my goodness. It is by Alex Pagnol and the art is by Dio Neves. What the? Okay, I never thought I would see Marvel go this dark. And I said the exact same thing about DC when they went with Action Comics, the Warworld saga. But this is a whole nother level of dark. Like, everybody in the city is falling apart. So Spider-Man, every 3 hours, has to keep them held together by his webbing. And he's even doing so with Gwen Stacy, which is, in this story, the love of his life. And they're trying to figure out, him and Mr. Fantastic are trying to figure out a way to prevent this from getting further. Spider-Man kind of gets to the point where he's losing it. And he uses, spoilers, he uses Mr. Fantastic as webbing to keep people together and it works better. But he's in pain and then Spider-Man just completely loses it. Completely loses it. And wow, like it was really, really good. I was shocked at how good it is. So then for number 5, I have the conclusion of Eat the Rich. I've talked a lot about this series on this channel. It is by Boom Comics. It is written by Sarah Gailey and the art is by Pius Bach. It's phenomenal. It is so weird, but so good. You have this lady that is in a romantic relationship and they're going to meet his parents and, you know, the parents are upper class. Well, it comes to find out that you actually have this woman and this whole entire family and community are cannibals and they eat the help after a certain amount of time. But then to add insult to injury, the help actually knows about it this entire time and they are okay with it because they are well compensated. And then there's this romantic relationship that kind of forms between her and one of the people that help around the house. And the boyfriend asks her to marry him. And she basically is drugged, has no way out. And then we see what happens after that. But I really, really enjoyed this series. It is over now, so it probably would be easy to pick up on trade. And it's definitely worth it. I really, really enjoyed it. Number two. And this story wasn't even that great. It was the art that I picked this one for. And I have Nightwing 87. Oh my goodness. Bruno Redondo, every time he is on the art of any book, really, really kills it. And this book is one continuous panel. One continuous panel throughout the entire book. And somebody steals Bitewing, Bitewing, Bitewing. I love Bitewing. Somebody steals the dog, right? And that is really what this story is Dick tracing where this person went along with Barbara. She ends up showing up and going to get Bitewing back. But the art is so neat and it's such a new, fresh concept. And it's really rare we see something like that nowadays. So I was really impressed with how Tom Taylor and Bruno Redondo put this together. Which leads me to my number one pick of the week. And I actually, to nobody's surprise, probably zero people's surprise, I have One Dark Night number one. This is by Jack, the art and the story. It is a Black Label book, and I have been looking forward to this for some time. I love Jack's work. I love the way he does this. And this story is going to be three different issues. I wish it would have started a little later in the story, but we learn about a man named EMP. And he is in transfer, and they are trying to take him. And during that transfer, we have a massive explosion. This man can absorb energy. And because he does so, and we have this explosion, we actually see the entire city go dark. And hence the name, get it? One Dark Night, get it? Super funny play on words there, right? Okay. Jack does a phenomenal job of setting this up. He actually not only gives us a little bit of stakes between Renee and another one of the cops, but he gives us stakes between even Alfred and Bruce, even Bruce and Gordon. And then we have these awesome, I absolutely love these maps he puts in. Really, really fresh, unique kind of story. Fresh and brand new villain. And honestly, this is nice to see. I was not impressed with the imposter near as much as a lot of other people. I thought it was okay. I didn't think it was something necessarily to write home about. But this book actually outdoes that in one issue. And that's pretty dang good. So definitely worth reading. So let me know, of course, what you guys picked down below. And I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.